Welcome back to my channel. I'm Joy, and this is Life is a Joy, mother, sister, daughter, and friend. Yes, I'm back with another video, guys. I'm on my way to my office for a meeting, which is really not at my office. It's close to my office. It's in Lake Lanier. If you're in Georgia, you know Lake Lanier. That's a whole cemetery. I kind of hate going there. I've never gone there for like a barbecue or like to stay at the lodge or swim in the water, because so many people have died there. So, but I'm going for the meeting. I'm gonna be running late because I was answering calls up until I left the door. Had to get dressed, do a little face or whatever. It says I'm gonna get there at 1:20. I'm supposed to be there at 1 o'clock. So hopefully they're not too mad at me. I'm on my way. But I have a story time for you guys. But because I'm in such a haste right now,
stay in the left 3 lanes.
And as you see, my navigation is on. So I'll wait till I'm coming back from the office, from the meeting, and then I'll tell you guys my story time. So I'm in the car, on the highway, trying to stay focused, and I'll give you guys a holler. Well, I'll pick up the camera back again when I'm on my way back from the meeting. So I'm back. The meeting was successful. I had a good time just, you know, getting, you know, the thanks and the praise for the job that we do, because we do have a very hectic job. You know, my phone rings nonstop. I'm going to cut the navigation off as soon as I get on the highway. And I wanted to give you guys a quick story time. I'm a sugar baby. I'm old now, but I am a sugar baby, y'all. Okay, I'm focused. I ate a little bit of something. My blood sugar is back. So I wanted to tell you guys a story time of when I became a sugar baby. So I'm from New York. I live in Atlanta. I take frequent trips to New York. And this was like back in, I want to say 2017. I was taking one of my frequent trips that I go to New York for the weekend. So I'm on this plane and I'm going back home now. I'm going back from New York. So from New York to Atlanta. So I'm in a middle seat. I'm 6 feet tall. Stressed out in the middle seat. But I met a nice gentleman and he was like, let's switch. Older gentleman. I'm like, okay, I'll switch with you, sir. Okay, I want to talk about the time when I became a sugar baby. And I wasn't setting out to be. Now, you know, there's dating sites, you know, for sugaring, because at one point I was really interested in that lifestyle. I was dating and all the guys I was dating were like broke, period. They were either broke or they were like just wasting my time. So I was like, forget about that. Let me just become a sugar baby so I can just get somebody to pay me to waste my time. Because, you know, they just be wasting your time. So, I was doing that, but I wasn't really getting no good hits. I did meet a doctor that we clicked, but that's a whole nother story time. So, I'm sitting on this plane. I think I'm on a Delta flight coming from New York back to Atlanta. In the middle seat. Guy, he's sitting next to me. He's like, I'll switch with you. So we wind up talking. It's an hour and a half flight. Normally I take a nap, but he wanted to talk. So I talked to him. He was just telling me about his life and this and that. And we had a great conversation talking about the new age kids and the disrespectfulness and the violence and the difference between Atlanta to New York as far as money. We just talked about a plethora. We had a great conversation. As the flight was landing, he was like, you know, take my number and call me sometimes because I would like to be your friend. And I was like, meh, you know, that's not really my zhuzh, normally older men. I mean, I'm 40, so I'll do a cool 45, 46. I might even go up to 47 and 8, but all that 50 and 50 plus, y'all leave me alone because y'all be having a lot of health issues and y'all be wanting a nurse. But we're not even gonna go there. So I met another man with the same name. So we're gonna say both of these men's names was Ray. right? So I had two Rays now in my phone. But the one Ray, he was the lawn guy. And he also was an older gentleman that was trying to kick the Willy Bobo. And if you don't know what the Willy Bobo is, the Willy Bobo is the game that men give you to get the cookie. So he was another one that was kicking Willy Bobo, but I never really paid him attention. But I needed my grass cut. So this is 2007. I'm in another house, not in the house that I'm in now. I'm in another house, and I needed my grass cut. So I called the wrong Ray, right? So when I called, so the phone is ringing, and I look down at the phone, and I realize that it doesn't say Ray Lawn. It just says Ray. So I'm like, damn. So I hang up because I didn't mean to call Ray from the airport, from the plane. I meant to call Ray, the lawn guy. So I hung up real quick. Of course he called me back immediately. He said, oh my God, Joy, I've been waiting for you to call me. Mind you, he had my number as well. So that was the weird part right there. Because it's been since I met him on that plane, it was probably like a good 3 or 4 months had passed. But he's been waiting for me to initiate because he told me, call him. So he was literally waiting. I was never going to call him, to be honest. Ever. Because I can tell he was a man of a certain age. He was definitely... He could be my father. I'm going to leave it right there. So he was like, I've been waiting for you to call me. This, that, and we had such a great conversation. I went back and I told all my coworkers, I told my sisters, I told everybody how much, you know, I clicked with this lady on the plane. We're gonna go back 4 years ago, you know. I was like 35, 36, or whatever. So, you know, it is what it is. So, we talking on the phone, and he's like, you know, I really need somebody to talk to. Would you accept my, you know, my call? Sometimes I might call, and I just want to talk. And I was like, sure, you know. If I'm not busy or whatever, I'll speak to you and talk to you. He was like, fine. He said, I want to send you something. I was like, send me what? He was like, give me your full name, and I'll go to Western Union, and I'll send you something. And I was like, what do I got to do for this? Because, you know, it's nothing for free. So I'm like, oh, God. So I'm getting nervous or whatever. So he sends me. We do all this transaction or whatever. I'm going to say 3 days. Everything got settled as far as him being able to get to Western Union and everything. And he did. And he got there. And this man sent me $400. So I call him. I said, thank you for the money. I appreciate it. Why did you send me this money? You know? He was like, because I want to. Okay. So, four. And believe it or not, guys, I have multiple stories. Multiple. This is just one story of me becoming a sugar baby, unbeknownst to me. Me just being friendly and being cordial with the older gentleman, and they just want to give me money. So, for 2 years, guys, Ray sent me weekly stipends at Western Union for, it was a better part of 2 years. I want to say about a year and a half plus. It wasn't completely 2 years. He sent me every payday. He got paid every week about anywhere from $200 to $400 every week for about 2 years for no reason. Just because I picked up my phone and I answered it. And I talked to him. I'll tell him about whatever issues I was having. I'll tell him about, you know, whatever's going on in my life with the children, with work, and everything. And I would listen to him and he would listen to me. And then he'll say, take this number down. And it'll be the number to retrieve the money from Western Union. And honestly, he was trying to link up a few times. He did, but I always figured out a way not to link up because I felt like this. Why do I have to do anything if I never had to do anything? So I wasn't going to start a new trend. So I never met up with him. So just recently, he's contacted me And I was in New York. He was en route to New York. He lives in New York, but he comes back and forth from New York to Georgia to Alabama. He travels a lot. Not for work, just because he can. He works. He still works. He's a working man. He works every day. And he does hard labor. When I showed my best friend his picture, she refers to him as one of the five heartbeats. Because he has like a bouffant. He has curly hair. I don't think he has permed. I think he just naturally has a curly hair. He has like a bouffant. Like, he gives you the five heartbeats, the Temptations kind of look back in those days. That's how, so you know, that says a lot about his age, right? But he's a sweet man. And he's such a sweet man. But anyway, about, I want to say, back in like about 2019, he was trying to meet. We weren't clicking, because I knew what I was doing. I wasn't trying to meet, you know, for what? I wasn't sexually attracted to him, so I didn't see any reason why we would meet outside of just having some dinner, maybe just talking some more, because we just always just, we're phone buddies. So, just recently, he's been contacting me. And he says to me, I said, wow, you haven't called me in a long time. I said, I called you. I haven't gotten in contact with you. It's been about a year. The pandemic happened and everything. How you been? How is everything going? He said, baby, if anything happened to you, my sister's got all your information. I don't know what that means. I pray nothing happens to him. I pray he still has many more years to live. He's a hardworking man. And the reason why I thought about calling, telling you guys about this, because he called me today. He said he wants to talk to me. So, of course, I will talk to him. We're going to have our conversations like we always do. But I wonder if he wants me to be his sugar baby again. But guys, I have so many stories. And, you know, I'm a cute chick. You know, I'm a cute chick. But people assume that a sugar baby needs to be in shape, always, you know, needs to be on top, designer clothes, dressed to the nines. Trust me, I had on spandex and Uggs when I met that man. And he accepted me for who I am and who I was at the time. And I was going through a lot of financial struggle, and he knew some of it he did not know, but he just always wanted to be a helping hand to me in my life. And he never had any expectations. He never said, well, I'm gonna send you this money, but meet me at this hotel, or I'm gonna send you this money, I'm gonna come to your house. And you know, it was never that. It was always, excuse me, him being genuine, respectable, and very honest. He was a very honest man. Now, if I call him, I tell him about my financial stuff, and he'll tell me, well, you know, you shouldn't have did this, shouldn't have did that, do this or do that. He would give me advice financially and how to do certain things and how, you know, how to save my money and how to, you know, spend my money correctly. But he never judged me. He never disrespected me. And he always was a friend. And although, this is the last time he sent me money, probably, was sometime in 2019, I'd still be his friend today. He doesn't have to send me anything. He was such a sweet guy. He is a sweet guy. And he will always have a place in my heart, because most men expect something from you. There's very few men that want to help a woman without getting anything in return. I appreciate that. But like I said, guys, I have so many stories where older gentlemen or my age want to help me in a way where I don't ask them for the help. They just give it to me. And I think that that is God. People might laugh at this, but God works through people. And if you don't believe that, think about your life. Think about how you received the blessing that came through someone else. Guys, I was in so much financial debt. And I just, out of nowhere, just got an extra income every week. That was God. It was God. And that's a blessing. I try not to block my blessings. My sister said, oh, you like to... you have patience for foolishness. Now, what she deems foolish and what I deem foolish are two different things. Because having a conversation with someone that's not hurting me, he needed companionship. He needed someone to vent to talk to be able to say good morning to, good night to, how was your day? How was your day going? Have you eaten? Did you take your medicine? He needed that from me, and I was able to give that to him. And I needed his words of encouragement. I also needed the money. But when I met him, none of these things ever went into my mind. I thought I was going to meet him. I got his number. I knew I wasn't going to never call him. I knew that. But God works in a way where I called him instead of the lawn man. So don't block your blessings, ladies. Sometimes be a friend to someone that you wouldn't normally be friends with. Have respect for people, different walks of life, from different places in the world. And God will bless you for it. And that's what I think is for me, because I always have an open mind. I'm always nice to everyone. And like I said, what you may think is entertaining foolish things, for me, no one is foolish. No relationship is not for any reason. Every relationship that's in front of you, whether it's forever relationships or relationships that are for a time, for a season, it's still a bond that you created with a person. And even if that time has expired, it still existed. And I'll never forget him. And we'll always remain friends. He called me earlier today. I was at a meeting. I called him back. And that's what made me want to talk about him today. But Ray, God bless you. That's not your name, but you may see this, you may not. I thank you. And I'll always thank you. And now, God, thank you that I'm not in a position where I need someone to help me pay all of my bills. It wouldn't hurt. It wouldn't hurt. But there was a time in my life where I needed that help, and God blessed me with Ray. Anyway, guys, that's it. Comment down below. Tell me what you think. Tell me if you ever was a sugar baby. Tell me if you had a sugar daddy. Tell me if you had to give any sugar up, because I never did. And I have another story. And if you don't believe me, I have more stories. And I probably can even give you guys receipts, because I have another story, you know. But I'm looking at the time. Vlogmas day 6 or 7, wherever we're at. We'll go back. If you want to hear another story about me being a sugar baby, comment down below. Bye for now.